Throaty noise you hear coming from an inverted V V8 Argus engine. That is the thirsty beast. That's the only meaty part of this entire airframe, to be perfectly honest. There he is, bringing it back in again to the most remarkable touch and go. Like I say, barely 100 metres apart. Extraordinary, the range and versions that this aircraft was involved with, counterinsurgency work, some had machine guns in the side windows, they had bomb racks, smoke laying, and there was even an anti-submarine version. The French came up with a five-seat civil version, and all powered then with a 233 Renault engine at that stage. And here he is now, literally coming into the hover. Barely a forward airspeed of around 10 miles an hour, maybe, if that. And he can probably hang around there for quite a long time. Of course, this sort of work, obsolete in today's modern warfare, one of the great problems is that you cannot protect this class of aircraft from ground fire or missiles of any sort, so very, very vulnerable indeed. So Peter calling up now, this is his last pass coming up, and said it's a real pleasure in a way that it's not happening very fast. It's superb to see. So as he comes back, ladies and gentlemen, please give Peter a great wave, won't you? It's a really, really superb aircraft, a great experienced hand there, Peter, and just superb bit of flying. Barely dropping it down, it's almost a vertical descent at these sort of airspeeds. It's quite astonishing. Utterly beautiful, glinting in the sunlight there, in that fabulous silver colour scheme. Of the day. In the hands today of squadron leader retired Dave Piper, who's the operations director and pilot with the recently formed mid-air squadron. His long association with the camera began in 1979 on 360 squadron at RAF Witten, following training on the Joint Provost, the Hawk and the Jetstream. Squadron and 58 squadrons. In the early part of its life, it was used by the Royal Air Force for trials work, including a period at Boscombe Down, the military flight test establishment. When I was told by a very experienced test pilot yesterday that as long as you did enough of those on a meteor beforehand, that this was no effort whatsoever. It was one of five aircraft selected for a complete refurbishment in the early 1980s, and it included the installation of advanced American surveillance equipment and a data link system, such as that used in the Lockheed U-2. It became a prized asset for use in all sorts of reconnaissance roles, right through the 1990s, and even into recent conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan. Since its refurbishment, it was sprayed in the mid-air squadron silver livery. It's a great shame that we are unable to do the pairs formation 2007, and not surprisingly, he's got a few hundred displays on his record logbook as well. This is the ultimate Canberra variant, the PR9, and he returned to flying that in 2004 at 39th Squadron at RAF Marham, where he became the Flight Commander of Operations, seeing service in Europe, the Middle East and Afghanistan. This 2014 Air and Country Show at Abingdon, and